the lecture is donation. What I will tell you now, I recommend only to extremals. Don't think that it's common for all. I don't offer this for everybody, because for somebody it may be too hard. At that time, I rented a flat with two rooms. I had an old cupboard from the old owner. You know, an old stuff of wood of the Soviet times. It was usually at the wall, situated at the wall. I found a board in this cupboard. It was a very wide board, the true Soviet Russian board. I do not know where they took it, but it was a great tool for austerity, okay? My daily routine was the following. I got up in the morning about 6 and had pranayama. Then I went to my first training in the morning. Then I came back home, cooked breakfast and had breakfast. And then I waited. It was easy during the day. In the afternoon I had practice, it was bearable. But in the evening, when I came back home, after the evening practice, I had an hour of austerity. I sat down respectfully on this board. I underlined nothing purposely in order to practice seriously. And I suffered. I sat in Padmasana. It was not always Padmasana. Sometimes it was Siddhasana, but mostly I sat in Padmasana. I had the rules, austerities in the evening hours. There was sweat and tears. It was August and it was very hot. Accordingly, in the evening I opened the window. But the fact that the leg which is under when you sit in Padmasana, one leg is higher, the other is lower, is always sweating harder than the above one. And I had got used to the fact that when you got up of this border there, always was a puddle of sweat. The sweat was dripping. Well, I didn't care about this. One morning I got up. I had practiced quite good in the evening and suddenly I saw that the puddle is on the spot. I didn't understand what it was because it usually evaporates in the night. So the sweat evaporates and there is nothing left. But there was a puddle on the spot. I touched it and found that it was greasy. It was greasy sweat and therefore it did not evaporate. But on the other hand, try to understand me. I had a goal. That is why I tortured myself. I had a number of questions that nobody could answer. There were no sensible books, and my sister tried to take me to psychic. I see certain things that other people don't see. There are two ways. It is okay or you should go to the mental house. Well, I listened to some foolish things and decided to do yoga myself and to look for the answers myself. This hard effort gave me this certain result. As a result, I have managed to take my consciousness out of the body and to watch my second body, and I found the answers to some questions which fundamentally changed my life. That is, I saw something much more serious than the real world, to which we get used to. Then I went to find teachers who I could be taught. But it wouldn't be without that period when I just suffered an hour every day. I repeat again, every day from morning to evening, no weekends. I had such three strict approaches to my personal practice. I had pranayama in the morning about an hour, and then it was gayatri about an hour and 15 or 20 minutes, something like this. Wait, I'm sorry. I didn't just bear the pain. And I'm not a masochist to sit on the board and to bear the pain. I opened a book, a religious one. After the third minute, I understood nothing, but I read. I pretended I was reading and enlightening. How old was I? I just came from the army. I was about 22, probably. I recommend you that if you really want to reach some results, you should make efforts. It is not an easy way. We will talk with you today about what is easy. If you really want to reach a result, you should set a goal that you will need to overcome yourself, and not in a year, most likely. What you overcame in the beginning is just a cake compared to what will be when you become a yogi and begin to practice. Tests that will come later will be serious. I am telling the truth, and the truth has such a quality that it frightens cowards and it inspires the brave ones. If a person knows where he goes, he will move, and all cowards fall off, and basically it is for the best. And those who feel certain potential will go on anyway, and they won't be scared, so it is okay.
Да нет, вы что? Не было, конечно, потому что...
I will explain in short. Since my childhood, I see some things that nobody sees. Once I remember, we drove in the car with my dad in the Caucasus, and I asked him if he saw what I saw. He said that he didn't. Since then, I never asked anybody. I understood everything. And then I had to find the answer. You see the reality that others don't see. Yoga helps to find the answers to these questions. For many years I have accumulated a hunger to find it out. When I found out that there are austerities and practices, I thank the gods that the teachers were more or less adequate. If at that time it was Iyengar yoga, I only can imagine what would have happened to me. I would raise my hands and legs during 10 years. Concerning pranayama, it was a 12-story house, and I didn't care about this, and there were no variants. Today it will be quite an interesting lecture. So, if you are planning to get on the path of yoga, whether you like it or not, some difficulties will come to you. And the difficulties you face on your way are almost all the same. So, about these difficulties we will talk. And we also discuss the methods of overcoming these difficulties, how you can overcome that, what theoretically will want to stop you on your way. You probably practice yoga not the first year. But, by the way, let's make the statistics. Who of you practice yoga less than a year? Raise your hands, please. Okay, thank you. Who practice yoga less than half a year? Are there any? Well, and 2 years? From 1 to 2 years period? Well, thank you. From 2 to 3 years? I can see we grow. And then more than 5 to infinity. Are there any? Yeah, well, I'm very happy.
Хорошо. Ну что ж, видите, как замечательно у нас с вами. Тогда практически большинство, кто поняли...
The majority who raised their hands that practice about a year will have some certain difficulties. Ask you a question. Do you have any life difficulties in yoga? Laziness. Let's write them and analyze by the components. The first word I have heard was laziness, wasn't it? What else? Family, yes. Motivation. Injuries, right.
Травмы, да?
Well, let's analyze thoroughly.
Еще какие моменты?
What are the moments? Work. Let's write a loan. Yes.
Давайте напишем кредиту, да?
More difficulties, willpower. Well, it can be attributed to laziness. Conditions, housing problem.
Условия, слушайте, квартирный вопрос, наверное, да? Ну ладно, условия.
A good teacher is a relative concept. What will be the first 3 years? It is not what will be the next five. Once you outgrow your teacher, then you will look for a new one. What else? What obstacles do usually appear? You are seduced, right? The offer to drink tea once again. Okay, friends, what else?
Ладно, друзья. Зажирели, да? Друзья, еще что?
Well, actually, nobody has said the main obstacle. Well, addictions can be certainly written, so-called larvas. You are eaten by larvas. What else? Finally, we have come to the main obstacle, your relatives, the most important obstacle in the vast majority. No, family was said, but in another context, meaning no time. Your family will return you to the reality. They say that is not enough being nirvana. You should stop and go digging potatoes, for example. Let's write family, relatives.
Семья, родственники, да?
In my opinion, at least it is what I can see. Family is the number one problem for those who are just taking the first steps. All the other factors are for those people who are on the path but has already stood firmly. So to say, they have passed a certain test and try to move on. Then they experience all that we have listed. But your relatives is the number one problem in the vast majority of people. Because they will try to change you to impose their point of view, and you start to argue with them. Sometimes you can make some foolish things when you start treating your family members. You start telling them about vegetarianism and what is bad and what is good. Your compassion starts showing and you start to change them in the right direction, right? Violently. Well, not quite catch up and make good thing. Yes, yes, yes. The main problem is when you start to impose your point of view to your relatives. I can express my humble opinion on this topic. There is a good Russian proverb. A prophet is not recognized in his own land. It is in the broad sense. Because the main gist is that your parents can never treat you as a wise man. With the rare exceptions, but no matter how old are you, you will always be their baby. Moreover, the baby who always gets into all sorts of trouble. Therefore, your yoga is again another your trouble. For the first time, they will say that you do something foolish. Then the word sect appear in the lexicon of your relatives in 4 months, and they will try to change you. As experience shows, it doesn't make sense to do that, to treat your relative. If you are a still young man and your parents watch TV for 2-4 hours a day, more often, there is no sense to talk about. There are form templates and there is no sense to speak with them. It is the same as to prove something to the TV screen glass. The effect will be the same. The more you talk, the more you will be tired. No other way. But if your parents have some common sense, so try to bring to them the idea that you have decided to make an experiment. Tell them to give you 6 months to live as you want. Tell them that they had made you do some things you didn't want or you do the whole of your life. They were drilling you and you did all they wanted. You even had graduated from the institute they wanted you to study. But now you want to be a vegetarian and practice yoga. Tell them to leave you alone and try to understand that if in 6 months you won't cope with this, then you would talk about how to go on. But sometimes just try not to impose anything. This is my experience, certainly. You can give them some literature to read, but no more. In the beginning, you should be very careful, calm and loyal with your relatives. You should respect them maximum if it is your family, your parents, your father and your mother. You should understand that everything in this world is very difficult, especially with your close relatives. My mother, for example, is an avid Christian, but nevertheless, she makes a very good thing for me. For 20 years, probably, she strictly gets in front of her icon and she prays for all my relatives and for me in particular. She asks your Christian God for help, and this is the support anyway. Doing this, my mother really protects her children the way she can. No options. That fact that we ideologically are not compatible is actually not a problem. She does her job, I do my job. However, I realized that to argue with somebody is pointless, and I recommend you approximately the same thing. Try not to escalate the atmosphere in your family with your relatives in any case. Try to be as tolerant as you can be with them. In the future, everything will be okay. Perhaps when this hardship will pass, maybe during the first 2 or 3 years of the fight, when they try to turn you back. The same situation is with friends, but it is because friends tend to disappear. Whether you practice yoga or not, your friends will change every 5-7 years. It is very rare when people stay friends more than 10 years. Usually 3, 5, 7, maximum 10 years. Interests change. What are friends? Friends are those who together live fast life, so to say, have some interest to spend time together. If you have this pastime, there is an interest and we are friends. If this interest disappears, we are not friends anymore. Because there is no basis. You know, you need something to do together, drink together or smoke or go fishing. Well, what are other activities, so to say, to burn the time and often not in the best way? That is why sometime later you will meet very different friends. They will be updated, and friendship with yogis is a completely different level. But let's come back to the parents. Don't argue with your parents, please. Try to explain your position that you make an experiment. For example, let me try that. Nobody ever died from yoga. And you'll be fine. They even may believe you. The main thing is to leave you alone for some time. Sometimes I receive some messages when young people complain on that their mother prepares them ignorant food. I can't define now, but from time to time I receive some messages like this. I eat food at home, and it seems to me that is not gracious. What to do? What can I tell such person if he doesn't understand what to do? Just cook yourself or find some conditions to have another kind of food. If you don't like something, change the reality. To make your mother gracious in order to make her cooking you gracious food, it's absolutely absurd. Therefore, in this case, just leave them alone. If you are able to live separately, it's ideal way to live your life. You are all adult people, so it is the best way. So, has anyone heard that it is no use to argue with parents? It is not necessary to impose your point of view. Why do I say this so quietly? Because a family is a very complex structure. I can't probably explain many nuances. You won't believe what I am going to say. And if you don't believe, maybe it is possible that you believe in the future and you will understand everything. I'll just explain. It's no sense to explain some things now. Just imagine, I tell you, look, do you see this triangle? You see, you answered yes. Then I will say that actually this is not a triangle, this is a circle. And you say, well, what kind of a circle? This is a triangle. But to see that it is a circle, you will be able not immediately. Now you have already labeled the certain concept and the situations. And later in the future, even if you are close to the realization that it's actually a circle, I hope you understand that I absolutely aphorize. Because of this label, you will not understand important things. But it happens very often that your parents do you only good if they act incorrectly, or if you have a brother who is an alcoholic or a drug addict. Believe me, it is only for good. But for you, it can be probably unclear. Your family is a certain energy self. If there is a larva in this house or in this family, then it should take someone's energy. Do you understand the logic? If it won't eat you, it will take on someone else, and the one who will feed it will only help you. There is a metaphor or a proverb that if there are two mice in one box with a poisonous grain in it, one of the mice have to eat this grain. Do you understand the logic? Therefore, if one eats it, the other still might be alive. And our thinking is the following. The person around us behaves incorrectly from your point of view. You automatically want to correct them and their life. It is not always right. Here's the fact that I was told about the family in the future, that perhaps many years later you begin to understand how energies move. You realize that people around you degraded for, and you sit so calm. It's even hard to believe.
Они не расти помогают. Они на себя берут часть того яда, который мог бы вам достаться. Понятно?
They take part in this poison that you could take. If you are destined to withstand 5, 7, 10 years of yoga, then maybe you will move steadily.
Двигаться стабильно.
If you have people who you can help and to whom you can bring a certain good, then your life will have an entirely different meaning. All those who helped you in person or in advance when you thought that you were hurt, they really helped you. If they were not in your life, then you would have achieved nothing. They will receive a certain part of the gratitude that you have now. That is, you will already work for them. That is why there exists such theory, to leave all as it is in your family. There is even a picture mostly shown in the monasteries in Tibet, but very rare in India. It is called Shamatha. Different schools have different interpretations of it. Don't you have anywhere this picture, Volodya? Can I show it well? Well, just I show you this picture and I will explain it short. There is a small valley, a house and a river on it, and the climbing to the mountain starts. There is a winding path which has three curves, so to say the six chakras respectively, and then the flight begins. And there are some men in this picture. The first leaves the house, crosses the bridge over the river. Then we come to the first chakra, the first test. The elephant and the rabbit run with him on this level. No, the rabbit will be a bit later. There is no mind at the beginning. There is a monkey near the elephant. Respectively, then the monkey goes away. They rise as a crowd until the elephant is completely white and becomes one with the practitioner in the end. In different traditions, it is explained differently, but the average explanation is that you will have a certain test on your chakras. And if the monkey is your body, the elephant is your mind. And first time you like to follow the path of practice plain, only then the mind will understand that it is actually erased. If you really move, you'll replace the mind, which have formed on this life, on this planet. Maybe you will connect the mind which you have had from life to life. That is, you will bring your wisdom from your past lives. Your mind and your set will not be needed. It will be replaced. Shamatha explains a lot of things. First, to leave your home, maybe not in the literal sense, not in the physical, but in the secondary, that is, try first to find your way. Possibly in the future, if you are able to fix on the path of yoga, your relatives will understand everything and you'll be able to talk to them. But in the beginning, it is almost impossible. So, well, any questions or additions concerning this topic? Is everything clear with the family? Is it clear, more or less? Okay, let's go. Let's leave larvas for the dessert, because it is the most difficult topic. Moreover, it is also not so clear with the larvas. It is very complex. I don't know what I will tell you concerning this topic. In short, friends are the temporary phenomena. They are not friends for too long. Once you have lost some sort of passion that you had shared with your friends, nobody will be friends with you. You have friends because of interest. If there is an interest, friendship will be. No interest, no friendship. So take it easy. Some friends you used to drink together will go away. So this is okay. And to impose on someone, if the person is already alcoholic, to impose that you know you are really an alcoholic, as the experience shows, is not the most reasonable thing. I never do this for the last time. Though I was very stubborn and I always argued trying to impose my point of view. Then I realized some other things. If I have a kilo of energy for today, who should I spend it on? Arguing with an alcoholic, or maybe to do some other more or less reasonable thing, and for that person who understands the information 10 times fast. I have the tools of communication with the other people who practice yoga in the club. Therefore, I will spend my time on yogis, but not on alcoholics. But if you will teach yoga, not adequate people will come to you the first time. Be ready for this. This is a very hard challenge. I have not seen exceptions. Moreover, not just on adequate people. One guy told me one accident. I was stunned. In the localities near Moscow, this guy has a big sports center where he teaches yoga. He talked that one day they practiced yoga, there were about 20 people, and suddenly the priest came with the cross from the neighborhood parish. There is a church near this sports center, and it was said that yogis do yoga, and this priest came to drive out demons. I have not faced such situation. I even had no idea of something like this. It is fantastic. But it turns out that it can be. The suburb cities are usually very wealthy and the priests are more motivated for their flocks. And when the flocks thins, they try to find any reason who is to blame. In this case, the eye fall on yogis. I don't judge. The priests do very well, do very good things for certain old ladies. The old ladies just love them. Let them to deal with the old ladies, no problem. So, there are usually some problems when alcoholics and drug addicts come to you. You will see your own weak places that you can have in the reflection of the other person. This other person will come to you and drive you crazy. When a man comes to me, I understand who he is from the point of view of the energy immediately. So when I see that the person is a demon, I even will not talk. But the new teachers will have to talk to non-adequate people. That is, they will listen to them and so on. Therefore, develop your energy in order to listen not with your ears, but from the point of view of the energy to scan a person. We even had such precedents when we went somewhere. We left the club with someone. They had some sort of problem in the club, moreover, with neighbors. Once a neighbor came to fight. Terrible. But that's exactly the problem the teacher who was in the gym at that time. Let's come back to friends. I recommend you being friends with yogis. It is very good relationship. I do not understand any other relationships. Interests are different, quid pro quo. And the yogis have the only form when you need nothing from the others. So to say, it is very good to move together to development. And we do sometimes something together, and this is great relationship, very good. It is the common interest. Conditions. You have these conditions that you have created yourselves. If you say that you have no apartment, no room, and you live with the other five people with three and three dogs. Now, I have this karma, so how can I practice yoga? But friends, who do you blame? What were you supposed to do in your past life that you have such conditions in this life? Why so? Because you didn't move and burnt your life. Therefore, in this life, you have nothing material. There is another problem in the material aspect. It is your greed from the past. If in the past you could do something positive for others, you didn't do this, and say for yourself, greed towards anyone results into poverty, or to the fact that you live in poverty in this life. I give you an example. There is a box for donations. You can donate and people donate differently. Someone can give 1,000 rubles. Someone can give 50 rubles. I understand that we all have different incomes, and I absolutely don't care about who give and how much. But I will tell you a story. At the time when I met my first teacher, I discovered a strange thing. When I left my teacher, I left money only just to come back home in my pocket. But I repeat again that I have never been financially burdened. I knew that when I come to the city, I was able to earn money. I had no fear. But I do remember, when I gave money, I was surprised why I should give it. I didn't understand this with my mind. I just did. And then in the future, I have already realized. I have this quality from my past lives. If you have the opportunity to donate, this option should never be missed, because the money that you left in your purse will disappear. You can save it as you can, but they will disappear 100%. The only question is what they will be spent on. And of course, if you can invest the money into something more or less positive that will grow and do good to other people, this is of great, great importance. If you're a vaishya in this life and you work as a businessman or a craftsman, for example, and you can't practice yoga, but you want to have adequate conditions in your next life, you have had adequate conditions, find those who can be sacrificed for the benefit of the development of these people or the society as a whole. This is very important. Learn to give all things you have. This is just your conditions in which you are now. Of course, I exaggerate mentioning three dogs. When people complain how five of them can share the bathroom, this is your greed from the past. Try to change yourself in this life. I suggest you, I do not insist on it, but I'm sure it will be good. After some number of years, I understood that this law works. To find a teacher you can donate is extremely rare. Case. It seems to me that I told you this story last year. Many years ago, I was told by one friend. It was about how they brought money to one ashram. One man had some crazy money, and he was advised to invest it in some good thing and to an adequate teacher. They went and gave this sum of money to the teacher, and he told, because he was there and he saw it with his own eyes, how the skin of the teacher receiving this money became gray on the face immediately. This money immediately reflected on his aura, immediately. Why? Money, to put it mildly, smells bad. You can believe it or not, but it is the truth. When they say that money doesn't smell, it is not true. Money has a certain karmic load. I can tell you a lot of stories about this, but I think you should obtain your experience yourself. At least I got you the message, so think with your own head. Try, if you have some budget, to invest some sum of money in some good projects every month. Everyone will choose what sum of money, but try something to sacrifice. This is the treatment of your Manipura chakra. It is very difficult to give off anything to people who live at the level of Manipura chakra. For most of people, it is almost impossible. For Vaishya, the system of sacrifice is the output from the level of the Manipura chakra. I am often asked the question, what to do when you have the appetite, when people always want to eat and they are hungry, they can't stop, their appetite is very strong. This is the problem of the Manipura chakra. You cannot believe me, but if you donate money, the appetite will disappear. Do you think there is no connection? From the point of view of the energy, it is interconnected, because as long as you have used to pull everything to yourself, your appetite remains. Moreover, not just the appetite, but a very strong appetite. Once you start to learn to give up things, you change the tendency in your inner world. I have another problem now. I need almost to put it down, the time, eat. No time for eating, seriously, too busy. So for those people who has problems with the Manipura, I recommend to learn to sacrifice. You can say that you have no money, so just do something else. Give your energy, find some form of serving, do something for the development of the society. Now I will explain how it works.
У нас лярвы здесь, вот что, их нельзя трогать.
мы к ним еще вернемся, они важны. Вот есть?
Yesterday someone put 50 rubles into the box. Here, at this point, these 50 rubles we will try to use as efficiently as possible with our guys. We will spend it for some literature. We have special sum of money for it. Do you understand the karma of a person which has 5,000 rubles and have 50 rubles? Can you understand what sort of karma they have at the moment? 5,000 can be given by a man whose energy is more or less normal from life to life. So he can practice yoga in this life, and he is even financially independent. It is extremely rare, because there are two polarities and this man is in the middle. Do you understand the gist? Because if the man has no problems financially, for example, when he is burdened with the tangible assets, he can't practice yoga. He will be able to practice yoga. Do you understand why? Not, no? On the other hand, as it is said, a poor man, a person who is ready to practice yoga but who has no money. So the person who does yoga and who is financially independent is precisely the golden mean, which implies the growth of this person and the people around. So the 50 rubles given by the man is the most valuable money needed to invest with the maximum benefit for this person. The best way is literature, or basically we invest it in the promotion. For example, now we promote our club Aura, and it is minimum 15,000 rubles every month. Why are you laughing? I think to put 50 rubles into the box. A sophisticated female mind. Actually, there is a lot of spending. Why are you laughing? We spent about 50,000 for the preparation of this floor and that dinner room. We pay 70,000 to the developers of the new site of Aura, plus 20,000 for those who did this site. We almost put 90,000 into the new site of the Aura a month ago. Plus, we will invest another 15,000 every month until August. But if the money will be coming, and we will invest the next year too. Why are you looking at me so surprised? The first year, when Aura just began, thanks God that I have a good friend who is financially burdened, so to say, and who put 20,000 rubles for 8 months. Calculate the sum, and you will get the sum for advertising. For you, of course, for you. In fact, you are on the second place. The first thing is teachers who will teach here. We invest money for the teachers, first of all. This is the most important thing, and of course you will get some goodness, but how to explain it to you in short, the teachers are more important. So we invest money in them, and these 50 rubles we will invest in the advertising. In the near future we won't invest into books. We invest it into the advertising in order to someone will see it, come to us and receive some goodness. And the following year, his life will change little by little. What goodness will be brought to the person who gave these 50 rubles? On the basis of these 50 rubles, his vector of life has changed. According to his karma, he could live like a normal person, yes? But we invested in him 50 rubles. We only have the tool to help you to make this money work. On the other hand, it is the commercial break. Friends, donate more to the box and you will be happy. I would have smiled if it wasn't true, but it is true. I just know that because it's really so. Have you ever heard about such word Garudakshana? It means help in India. It is when a yogi or just a good person comes to a teacher, and the teacher always has a certain number of students and gives him money. He sacrifices, so to say. Do you understand the mechanism further? This money is used for the ashram development further, for a certain evolution within the walls of this particular ashram. What do you think about if the evolution happens, how it will influence on the person who has invested this money? Now I'll give you an example, a very specific and easy to understand. Please tell me, who has parents who can listen to you about the law of karma, your stories how you became vegetarians and then raw food eater? Are there a lot of such parents? One hand, two, three, four hands. Okay, thank you. And now tell, who has parents who won't listen to you? Well, is the issue over? I will tell you a story now. There is a camera in front of me. I'll tell you the story of this camera. I have one friend. He lives in Germany. He works very hard. He collects, I hope he used to collect the glove box in the assemblage department.
Перчаточные ящики, по-моему, он бардачок, да, знаете, вот закрывается.
He deals with plastic and rubber. It is almost impossible to breathe.
Это дышать невозможно практически.
But it is half a trouble. They work there in shift. In short, he has the night shift. When after a night shift he comes with those square eyes, and he wrote that he wanted to put money in some project, and if we had something. I said that yes. We had a project, we shot on a common camera, but it was very uncomfortable, because you need to put the button every half an hour. We needed to buy a camera that would be with the card to record. It is clear why with the card and not with the cassette, because it is such a headache with cassettes. And just 2 years ago, these cameras with the cards first appeared, 170,000 rubles, something like that. And suddenly the camera, which costs 95,000 rubles, appeared. The only camera on this in this price range still that gives a normal shot. I told him that we need this camera. He could give 2,000 rubles, which he gave to us, and we added the rest. So we bought this camera with the cards, batteries, and it came out about 110,000 rubles. So it was midsummer 2 years ago, and we had a seminar, and we took this camera in order to make a good film, in order to make good for the other people. But there was a problem. Our good boys wet the camera. The camera was out of order. We put 100,000 for the camera, but the camera doesn't work. Can you imagine? We came back to Moscow, the camera is examined, but it's not a warranty case because we have wet it. It became moldy and they can only change the whole board. And this is another 50,000 rubles. I did not understand. What a madness. I never had such a situation. My car works for 20 years and it doesn't break. So, in short, I realized that it should not be so. It turns out that we had a yoga teacher from Vladivostok who knew about our problem. She suggested sending her this camera and then sending with a sailor, a friend of her, to Japan in order to fix it. It took about 3 months to send it in the case in the good hands to Vladivostok, and then it was repaired. It costs $300 in Japan. It was returned and it works. It records the teachers we teach. It records everything. So to say, it works for our teachers. Do you know what happened to this guy? His parents began to listen to him. His mother became a raw food eater. His parents evolved. He is overjoyed. I will call him today. Most likely, he has even found another job. Are you talking about Zhenya? No, it's not Zhenya, it's Harry. Well, but Zhenya has his own tests. And I had a lot of such cases in my life, when it is clear that a man putting in something that gives goodness minimum to the world around. Do you remember the story about the man who gave 50 rubles? Do you understand that if a person begins to evolve, he cannot live only for himself. He will for sure shall share knowledge with other people who are able to develop. And then he starts to share. Therefore, the investment which you can do in the beginning will bring you maximum goodness. It is in fact, I say once again, you are all in different financial conditions. I didn't even plan to tell you about these donations. I smile every time because I live in Russia. We have returned from the Crimea, Ukraine, recently. Of course, it is a terrible situation there. It is clear. It wasn't even enough money for petrol. But that's okay. Try to understand that we do this not for money, but the logic of people is that the person should have some money to come, to leave and to go back. If the person can donate 5, 7, 10% of his budget for this trip for knowledge, what result will he get? What do you think? He lived 95% of his budget and 5% he donated for knowledge. What will be the effect? Right. He came for 10 days, lived 10 days, it was possible to come for one day and it would be the same. Well, I'm just kidding. Actually, everything is much more complicated. Try to understand that the yoga camp aura is not for earning money. I'm much more interested in teachers. In order to obtain some experience, so they can share knowledge then. This is an activity when a new teacher may have a lesson for 30 persons, for example, and this is a very good motivator for development. I just know it from my own experience. This is the help for them and for those who will survive, because they will certainly have some difficulty. Then everything will be very good. There is even a special lecture on this topic. I am always accused by greedy people concerning ill children and give help to them. Probably you have not watched this lecture. I often have to talk about this. Of course, if you have, I'm not afraid to say the following. If you have a sick child and a healthy child, it is better to invest in a healthy child in order to make him sick, in order not to make him sick. It's much more important. But for Vaishya, the greedy people, they are good, they are great. But if to compare Vaishya's greed with the greed of Brahman, so from the point of view of Brahmans, Vaishya are greedy. It is a priori. I explain the logic of Brahman. Why the homeless became homeless? What do you think? What karma had they accumulated that they have now such a result? Right. If you help a person with a negative karma to heal his body now, will it help him change his soul? Probably not. Therefore, Brahmans are recommended not to cure the material body, but to change the world, those who are still alive and healthy in this world, that in the future they will not become sick. That is to say, to invest in the future, but not to treat. There are some people who are recommended to treat those who are sick. But Brahman is recommended to invest in healthy people, especially if you have a child who is destined to live effectively. Then to invest in him is a big plus. If you can make this child a good man, it is good. That is, what karma will earn if you raise an adequate child? The topic is difficult. How should I answer and not to offend anyone? For Vaishya is recommended to treat and to help everyone. For them it is important to get rid of their self. Do you understand the logic? But if you have a kilo of energy, you can spend it on a child who is sick. But try to let your energy be put on 5 healthy children, so that in the future they do not become sick. Do you understand the logic? Because prevention is always much more effective than the treatment itself. It is better to prevent some troubles than to solve problems later. It is not greed, not fascism. It is Brahman's logic. Clear? Do you have any questions, comments on this topic? Let's go further. Conditions. Donate if you can. Bring knowledge to the others in this life. Everything will change in your life. Do you have a question or just raise your hand? Kriya Yoga. You need to transfer your energy from the level of Manipura to Anahata level at least. For example, you loved someone. Everybody has such experience. You know what it is. When you love somebody, you do not want to sleep. You do not care what it is. You are only interested in love. But usually, when a man loves, he has no appetite immediately. Did you notice? This is the work of Anahata chakra. As soon as the energy was pulled out, you will not be interested in the Manipura chakra. Kundjala is a very good practice. Here is Roma, the specialist in Kundjala. Roma, raise your hand. No, you are not a specialist. Is Volodya a specialist? Volodya can tell it in detail and clearly. Why do you have your work? I understand that you have taken the loan, but why did you take the loan and now work? Because the advertising was showed. And why did you believe it and took a loan and now work? Why did it happen? Who remember the name of a French film about advertisers as they corrupt society? 99 francs. You are absolutely right. I recommend it who hasn't watched it yet. And there is a German film on this topic. I watched it a long time ago. Download this film and watch it. It shows approximately 10% of the advertising world reality. Because the advertising world is much tougher in the world than in Russia. There is another German film. The gist is that the director of some very popular TV shows makes a competition where the gist of this popularity is to choose for a girl a donor. Not to be said having the children here. And they compete between who come faster. They have a resounding rating and this man sits on drugs. This is a very good film. It is about 10 years. Finally, he understood everything and realized that he cannot degrade society anymore. And he made a revolution, he finds resistance, and he struggles with the TV show program, which is for not clever people. Why so? Because it is the order for such people on TV. It turns out that there are families which are set a special TV which has feedback. And such families are unhappy, to put it mildly. And as a result, the so-called rating is formed depending on which channel is watched by this unhappy family. And the rating is not good, since not clever people basically have TV. So it is the logical explanation. Do you understand? And the revolutionaries changed the rating, having changed all these boxes in the houses. And they began to show films about development, about the nature, some intellectual films, and people began to develop. And some people didn't like it, of course. The film is old, about 10 years probably. In fact, the media have a very strong impact on how you live. I just wanted to say this. According to your karma, you came into this world where you have been influenced by advertising. Thanks God that I was born when we didn't have such advertising. And thanks God I began to practice yoga and refused watching TV when there was not so much advertising. Otherwise, I was made the same user, I guess, if I watched TV. Although I never had a big wish to watch, but in fact, because of your bad karma, you have what you have. If you, like a slave, should go to work, friends, in your past life you just waste your time. The resources that you had been invested nowhere. Yesterday, when we were talking about how to prepare to your past life, unfortunately, I forgot to tell you three things. From this life, according to the writings, you can take with you only three things. Being in the human body. First, you can take your wisdom. This is the ability to distinguish correctly the reality in front of you. If you have wisdom, no matter in what world you can come, you will be able to live adequately anywhere. This is very important, because if you have no wisdom, but dullness, in any world in which you will get, is likely to be very small chances to live adequately. The second thing is your karma. Moreover, both negative karma and positive karma. Moreover, what karma which you will receive as retribution, or that karma which you will receive as welfare. It is important to understand that your ability to the adequate life is made by your past karma. If you help to go on the path of self-development in your past lives, you are helped in this life. It is all interconnected. And the third thing is your experience in practice. Experience is in yoga is probably better to say. Just only these three things you can carry with you in your subtle energy body in the future. What does it mean to have experience in practice? Have you noticed that doing an asana, you just know how to make it, you remember how to do it? Did you have this? Those who had, raise your hands. Look, it's cool, because it is the experience of the practice from the past life. Moreover, was I asked a question about six yogas of Naropa from your audience? It was the question about the six yogas of Naropa. I told you that it was a complicated topic. You can consider it in a different way, and even if you have the test of six yogis of Naropa, but if you don't have a teacher who can explain the important moments, you will receive the negative result, even trying to practice according to the texts. And the second thing, there are certain things inherent only in you. If you practice, you will understand what, where, when, and how to do it. There are such nuances that you will never find recorded on the paper. It is only transmitted on your sub-level. If you practiced, you save this and you will recollect it with your consciousness and you will move on. You'd practice. That's why tomorrow I will give you a lecture. If you try to do as the teachers of the past lived and practiced and developed, so each teacher needs to find a receiver or receivers, one, two people who can give the maximum exclusive things from the point of view of self-development. So, if there is a teacher who has millions of followers, why does he choose only one to whom he gives some exclusive things? What do you think? Okay, we will discuss this topic tomorrow. All your material wealth, all your material fortune, all your amount of emotional things, sensual things, no matter you dance or you sing or you have fun, will stay in the material world and you won't take all this. No matter how many lovers or loved ones you will have, how much good things you will have that everybody wants, you leave everything in this world, and only these three things will go with you. There is an important thing. Are there people for whom to see the mistake on someone's experience is enough?
Жареный петух не клюнет, хотели сказать, да? Я понимаю вас. Ну, пока, надеюсь, вы таких не встречали. Как раз-таки многого достигают те, кто учится на чужих ошибках.
If a person will regularly step on the same break, he can move neither in yoga nor in anything else.
Ну, это в лучшем случае даже. Хорошо, у учителя завтра, надеюсь, мы с вами поговорим на эту тему.
Your work is due to your activity in the past. If you live for yourself, trying to burn your life for yourself, you have the result that now you work like a slave. You are burned at the level of Vaishya, and you are exploited. I should draw these four categories, otherwise you will not understand how the law of karma works. Smert. Веся, Найт, Сосера. I give the Slavic names. In India it is respectively Shudra, Vaishya, Kshatri and Brahman. The only difference is the degree of selfishness and the degree of involvement in the passions. That one has 1% passions, this has 50%, this 30%, this 5 or 10%, whatever. An adequate sage tries to go away from passions and to put all his energy into some projects or students or some things connected with the development, because he knows that he was reincarnated with the conditions that he became a sorcerer exactly due to the fact that in his previous life he gave things to the other people, and these people reincarnate and who are more focused on some things. So what you are addicted as a result Now you have. It turns out the human body is only half trouble. It is important where you will go away and in what quality you will go away having lived your human life. Shudra has 1% passions in this life because he lived because of passions before. He stepped on a rake again and again, but nothing changed. Vesya has 50% for society, 50% for his passions, so he is like a slave. That's why you work now. What do you want? To eat fish and to pass the bones. So to say that I was good and someone else also. Such karma goes from life to life. Not adequate people write this basically. Any person who understands will never write about this and write those who can't think it up. So, that is why people need to be explained. Friends, you lost everything because you didn't think about the main thing. If in this life man was born a yogi, but he'll practice yoga for himself, yesterday a man asked the question, how to be if from the one hand you are a yogi, from another there is a tree, a house, a family, right? We had a discussion with this man yesterday. Try to understand that if a person does yoga for himself in his next life, he will be a slave. He'll just live his life. I told you a story. A guy had two apartments. He lived in one and another was rented. He closed for 3 or 4 years and practiced yoga for himself. He was brought food, money, but he was practicing only for himself. It was the zero result in 3 years. No result at all. He lost 3 years. Moreover, this kind of life for myself gives negative side effects. A person really develops his power. He indeed becomes more sensitive, but the problem is that when he goes into the society with this sensitivity, into the society he suffers very much. He will rush from the society like from a leopard dog. Is it clear? He can't find how to cope with the society, and it turns out that he will again make a shelter for himself. He will live as an isolated man from the society, so to say. What will be with him in his future life? What do you think? In the future life, there will be no two apartments from the family, and he will work at the best way. It is very good if at the factory. If he will be born in a country where a small percentage of unemployment. If the unemployment rate will be significant, and he only has his yoga tricks, definitely he will. No, he won't bend as he used to. It is extremely rare who can create his own club. Most often, the first year, a person needs to obtain his own experience. He has to work for someone else. It is not better. Tell me, please, the most glamorous profession. Well, a lawyer, for example. Glamorous, yes? Whose interests does the lawyer serve? Correctly, debaters who divide the assets. What is their karma? Those who share the assets and the lawyer who helps them to resolve these situations. Right. Does the lawyer get the karma of it all? Yes, of course. Let's go further. Lawyer who sits in the office. I can't imagine any lawyer who would have worked and who would have been paid just for sitting in the office. It is terrible when I face the notary concept. People burn their enormous potential. They are paid for signatures. Think about it. Can you imagine what will happen to such a man in the future? So, friends, any sphere of manufacturing is harmful for this planet. There is no manufacturer on this planet which would bring real goodness. It is extremely rare. If there is an eco-economy of the huge size, that brings healthy products to the society, and they have a lawyer with a notary. It's on the verge of fantasy. And everything else is not good, because in any case the person will receive only money. It is only paid for that certain mechanism that don't work for the better. And because the motivation of the entire world is not gracious now, so the non-gracious karma will affect any cog in this mechanism, my great regret. Maybe after some time there will be companies or corporations who will produce only gracious things. The lawyers may need to be there. The relationship will be quite different. I remember once I came to one planet. You know, it was almost paradise. It was so great and wonderful there. Everything was good, correct, clean and tidy. But I don't think the people who live there can develop just like you, because when everything is fine, there is no motivation for development. Your job is your stupidity in your previous life, your laziness and your ignorance. Greed, waste of resources. Now life has forced you to work there, and there are some examples, there are few, but believe me, there are some other examples. So, trauma is not an argument at all. It is necessary how to talk on this topic on injury prevention. There is such a feature in the society, injury prevention. It was completely invented in the Western society. A normal Hindu guruji will be very surprised having heard about such a notion. Don't believe me. Let me give you an example. The safest yoga from Iyengar. In fact, there is everything for the safety of the recipient. But open his own book. Let's open and read this story. I recommend reading it for those who has not read it yet, especially the followers of Iyengar, about the life not of the ancestor but Guruji. Iyengar's teacher made him break his body at least 2 times. And treated him maximum unmerciful. That is, there was not even risk of injury. Don't take my word for it. You will be very surprised. Iyengar himself literally says that he taught with a stick. Do you think because of the good life? He said that they were doing the asana incorrectly. I have already told you, they use the stick in 2 ways. First, to align the asana, and then later to stimulate to do this asana properly with the stick. I'm kidding, but he says that indeed, from the point of view of the Indian yoga, the teacher who beats his students takes the karma of his student on his himself, and Iyengar literally wrote that under his clothes his entire body was in eczema. It is true. I know for sure that one who causes problems to his student takes his karma, and in India everyone knows that. Therefore, there is no such a notion as injury prevention in India. There are 2 categories of ashrams there. The glamorous one for Europeans and accordingly for Hindus. And it is not the same. These are diametrically opposite things. For Europeans, it is yoga by form, and for Hindus, in fact, the concept of injury prevention is not, to put it mildly, far-fetched. Here's an example. In Ravesnik, we had only 2 injuries for the last 10 years. Perhaps there was some small, we didn't say about them, but I definitely know that there were 2 injuries when some guys hurt himself. But it is a trifle, a full trifle. Iyengar broke the spine to one of his students with his own hands, or even 2 spines. So he put the man into the asana so that he broke his spine. This guy has one normal leg, but the other suffers now. He was trying to correct the spine, but the nerve endings were disordered and the leg atrophies. I have just remembered about this case. Sorry. What is your question? He didn't beat him. He got him out of the window. He didn't hit. No. This is different. This was just an emotional outburst. Milarepa did a bit different. The man was forced to build by Milarepa. It is absolutely pointless and clueless. The man was given senseless tasks. Milarepa broke the man's self. It's a little bit different. Therefore, your job is your ignorance in the past. There is one limitation in yoga. If the person is mad, he is not recommended to practice. Give you an example about the mantra Om, which I forgot to tell you. Once we went to Italy in South Tyrol, in the Alps. There was a big hotel, most likely a Christian one, a diocese. Well, how to say, Vatican has big assets. It's 100% of their asset because there was a crucifix and the big Bible in every room. Well, they were not stingy, in fact. It was a normal European hotel and it was made in the form of the rectangle with a large courtyard. It was an eco when you talk, the real eco. So we practiced there and didn't bother anyone. One day we returned from the practice. We saw a lot of cars. There were good cars. They mainly drive not very expensive car in Europe, but these were very good cars, BMW and Mercedes. I thought it was a meeting. Well, it was not the usual crowd of people. There were some halls in this hotel. I thought maybe a meeting, and then I heard, because I had the windows just open onto the courtyard, how people gathered in the yard, stood in a circle and began to sing. It found out that it was Tyrol singing. Well, I listened to them, even made a record of their singing. And later I find out that they were the patients who came to treat their illness. Elena told about this. It is a national tradition, and the main concept is they were ill, mostly with heart diseases, and they came there to be treated by singing. It turns out that when a person has vibration here at this level, when we sing the mantra Om, for example, they have made studies and it was proved that while singing the scars were resolving. And literally the heart attacks and the signs of heart attacks were missing. And it was a big research, so now it is advertised as wellness sessions, and that all the ill people on big cars come and heal. So whatever heart you have, sing the mantra Om. You can read it. It is even recommended in order to more or less develop. You can also read a book about yoga. But if you're a blind man, you can listen to it. So to say, if you're interested in developing, you will always find the way to develop. But it is only a person is mentally okay. If there is some problems with the mentality, then that is indeed not recommended. Then you need to ask you a question, and why a man has a problem with the mind. Ask me a question, and I answer them. The problems with the mind is caused when a person names the black things the white one. Remember, I told you that you can take your wisdom and your karma, the experience of practice. So here's the thing that would have been a strange person, even if he does yoga for himself, but his karma, I don't know what to say, some things, take my word for it. But I have to say that it is the truth. Any yogi evolutionary is much above all other castes. because he is free from passions. That is according to the evolutionary level, this the writings say. And this is not my opinion. So, if someone makes bad things for yogi or the practitioner by coming down on them, you know what the consequences will be for the one who do bad things. Well, advise him, don't tell him, he won't understand. Advise him, if he lives in Moscow, to repair the chambers in Kashinka, to make Western-style renovation in the madhouse. It will be good for him in his future life. There are certain parallels in this, actually, because if the person comes down on someone who moves with a minimal amount of obscurations, he will have problems. I have to talk about this every time. There are maximum obscurations here. That is why the person doesn't understand anything except passions. Did you understand it? Here there are little, so to say, he wants to feed his obscurations and serve the society. Here even less. He protects the society but still has some obscurations. Therefore, no matter what kind of a person is the yogi, a strange or a skinny one, this is a separate category of people who move according to their own laws at all. I generally recommend practicing yoga. In short, the causes of injuries should be found in your last lives. So to say, why did you have some injuries? According to your karma in your past life. Don't try to get injuries, minimize them. Try to practice yoga adequately and dose it. I always say the following, there is the notion of pain and the discomfort. Practice yoga till the level of discomfort because nobody forces you to twist your leg behind your head or something like that. I even tell you that all these twisting are not from the good life. It is enough to make the average number of asanas and to practice with the society and everything will be fine. So to say, you will always have fresh energy with which you have to work through your body. Did you understand the logic? Not quite enough. Who did not understand it quite enough, what I said? Raise your hand. Okay. The usual yogi does some asana and does it the way he doesn't feel that he has reached the limit. The next stage, he begins to complicate this asana, so he twists even stronger than he did. He again doesn't feel something and then he twists more. He's trying to skip this discomfort through the asana to change the flow of the energy. Clear? That is why there are simple asanas, complicated, more complicated, and finally, there are asanas, which most people well are not real at all. So, if the man lives not only practicing yoga but also do some good deeds, he will always be in interaction with the society. The energy will always come to him, which even at the primary level will give him some discomfort. Clear? And then any injury is simply not real. Did you understand what I mean? Right. At the initial stage, it will always work on this level, and then the injury is excluded. If you practice yoga with your leg behind your head, or just to have a cool photo, of course, there will be injuries. It's absolutely okay, so to say. You should practice yoga and be not indifferent person, and there will be no injuries. Did all of you hear this? Because you are at this level and you will gradually move. Of course, I am talking about the basic asanas. You will not be recommended to do something that can hurt you, okay? I didn't say this. The writing says so. Look, open any book and look at the relationship between Brahmans and Kshatriyas. Kshatriyas are considered the best, but they always go to bow to Brahmans. Always. Okay, well, so about what examples do you ask me? In this case, I don't. If the knives were pumped, they would not have killed anyone around them, because killing doesn't solve the energy problem. So to say, the knife easily cuts off the head if he thinks that something was not right. The sorcerer will never do this, because cutting off the head does not eliminate evil. The sorcerer would give some method for the treatment of this man in order to become clear up. Killing is not the solution. Understand this. Well, this is one example. I repeat once again. Read the literature, you will understand everything. Well, unless, of course, you want to understand. Read Mahabharata, you will see the relationship between Brahmans and the knights. I told you this in the very beginning. I just gave you the Russian classification. It is almost the same. If you think that the sorcerer is somebody who walks with a stick singing songs accompanied by tambourine, it is just the fragments of what it once was. Right, it is so. They work in the office. Well, so, but nobody argues they have the right. The question is probably that he also practices yoga, but then, in fact, he is not a yogi. Who? Vesa, it turns out that he's not a sorcerer, but he can practice yoga. Give him time. Let's not to be in hurry. Most of you are Vesa too. No one knows what will be with you in 10 years. So the evolution is possible in one life. Moreover, because of what you hear now, many of you maybe have evolution. So did we finish with the injuries, okay? Do not chase stupidity and everything will be fine. It was written here. No motivation. Listen, if there is no motivation, just live as the others. Everything is not constant. You will have your body anyway, even this who has all fun now. Just what you said, who and how practice. According to the writings, Vesa were also given to practice yoga. They practice yoga already before their death. So to say, when there is already gray hair and the man begins to think and he starts to practice yoga, and in this case not even the asanas, but the inner practices. If they have a teacher whom they sacrificed or all their lives something material, well, so this Vesa comes to this man, to this teacher, to ask him how to transform, because it is clear how the relationship are built. It is a difficult question with the motivation. Listen, the internet is now full of different lectures of different people. Each category of students need their own teacher. Maybe you will find something for you. You will be motivated and probably will practice. Well, who said that there is no much motivation to practice? When there is a will, there is a way. Okay, friends, family. The cell of society, the family. It implies you, your parents, grandfather, great-grandfather or something like that. Seven bodies or so. A good cell of society. If you are still young and you don't have a family, practice yoga before it is too late. Because when you will have a family, there will be no time for yoga, as the quality of the family is very different from the energy with which you created this family. If you have the potential of training, practice yoga and after you will have a family. Your family will develop in one way. If you have a family first and then practice yoga, then yoga will be in 50 years, probably because the rest of the time you will have to spend on your family. So, while you are young, practice yoga. I will tell you maybe tomorrow or the day after about the benefits of practicing yoga before you have children, so to say that the children will come to you energetically developed. I hope we will discuss this topic tomorrow. In general, having a family is a good tool. For someone it is a rake, for someone it is experience. I always recommend yogis, if you are a yoga teacher, making a family. Have children so you have experience. A yoga teacher without children will not understand many things in this world. He will have some certain illusions. But if you have experience, what it is like to raise a child, what the child is himself, how selfishness develops in him. It is a very good way to watch after this world, therefore. I recommend to all teachers practicing for some number of years, then to develop your energy and then deliberately think about the children. Find a partner. Better to find a yogi. Why? Because, well, as experience shows, if one partner is a yogi and teaches it, and the other partner, for example, a vesya, well, a worker or a businessman, they will have many misunderstandings. Vesya will always be in passions. He will say to his wife that she became cold, but she was different when they had married, and why she became so cold. And for her it will be a very big problem, because it will be only passions and passions. She said to him to calm down, enough to talk about this. So it's better to look for a yogi for another reason. In the coming years on this planet there will be many interesting events, and it is believed that there is a large casting for many yogis to reincarnate here, to see life, how it all will be. But such yogi what? In this era, the tickets are not sold. They are earned by hard physical work, austerity. So to say, no finance will get you this era. And it is a slightly different case. There is a theory that there are planets where the perfect planets, the perfect sphere. There is nothing there, just a flat surface. And there is every meter of the surface, not in the rent, but how to say it, for many kalpas ahead is written for those who wants to get there. Because on this planet, when they come there, they incarnate it instantly, and it is only for yogis. And yogis sing the mantra Om there. For example, there is the mantra Om constantly, infinitely, and the casting to this planet is very huge. You can't get there for any money, it is impossible. Some yogis want to get there, of course, because of some profits, perhaps. What is the profit if you came to this planet at least once and established a karmic relationship with this planet? It means that there, whenever you come, you would come into your future lives. You have the so-called pass everywhere. It will be well everywhere because the channel leaves open and the energy will support you for a number of reasons. Accordingly, I recommend yogis, if you plan to be on this path for a long time, develop yourself and look for the right partner, give birth to yogi children. Children are given birth, so I'll talk in short, but it is in fact that the more you practice, the wiser will be the children from the point of view of convenience for you, because a normal child will drive his parents crazy. It is very hard to bring up a child, really. The more the child has egoism, the more gray hair the parents have. It is interrelated. The smaller ego, respectively, the smaller gray hair. So to say, it is harmonious relationship. It is almost as alias. You have a bit different situation because you are already burdened by your karma with the conditions. So take out of these conditions what you can do, so to say, take and do it better. Your kids are exactly what you need for your development and for development of your wife, and you need them. And do you want to say that they do not develop you? They do develop you, therefore be happy that they exist. There are no variants here. You should practice yoga anyway. If you are a clever man, you will understand. Yes, I probably won't be able to do what can do those who have easier karma than in my case. But nevertheless, you can make the efforts no less. Yes? I don't think because you understand the problem in one way with your mind, but not the fact that your jivatma shares the view of your mind. So, maybe you have a conflict, except that you have a human body and you already think about how to get into another conditions. So, that is ignorance. You can't change the circumstances which you probably want to change something because the circumstances are formed by karma. To whom you are born, you will have the same conditions in which you are now. Here, you can't escape. It is impossible to agree, because first you should agree with your karma, then no problem, it will bring you how to be properly. No, there is a topic not only when he was embodied, not embodied, and there exists a topic when, well, let's not discuss this topic, because no, that's not the point. And the topic of reincarnation is very dangerous for a number of reasons, not for us, but for the demon. Because they have such a quality trying to steamroll under themselves, and the things with reincarnation are complicated. I will give you one example so you understand. I have a friend who many years ago also wanted to obtain some experience from the point of view of yoga to check is it right or not. Are there any past lives or not? Are there any other planets or not? I don't believe. He's a good man with a higher education, so to say. He reads a lot. He's a smart guy, and I don't remember what he was doing. Well, somehow he could throw his consciousness out of the body, respectively, carry it into another planet and see that it really exists. So to say, he is experiencing all this, and the further he goes, the more the speed increases. And at a certain point, he realized that he has no brakes. So to say, he had gained the speed, but how to slow down, he doesn't know, and he really can't stop. But, you know, I have just told you about this so easily. But in general, in the end, he managed somehow to come back, and he was shaking for a long time. That's when he saw the truth, that is, his life is one thing, but the vacuum is another thing. The planet is another thing, and that different world exists. Well, I was watching him for some time. I saw him 10 years ago, and he was still shaking. So to say, his behavior was a bit strange, but he was so scared that time. But he also wanted to check how are the things there behind actually. Well, he had ambitions. So try to realize that, of course, he had been taught the lesson very hard. Maybe he was knocking the door, he wanted early to come, but the door was opened, closed, and he was sure to be happy to stay alive. That's why we say, when we read the mantra Om, I recommend you to raise your energy to the head, your consciousness to the head. Yes, because in some schools, they recommend to raise it above the head, as high as possible. But there were cases when they went higher. Well, and accordingly, it is possible for someone to go higher through the mantra Om. It is very good, but problems appear for those who have the body remained. What then to do with this body? So it is better not to go away in our club. Go away in somewhere other places. Well, friends, I think it is laziness. Well, listen, concerning laziness, look at this scheme. Laziness is here a priori. They are lazy to do something to practice. Look around. If you're satisfied with the world in which you live, then be lazy. If you are not satisfied, if you want to live a better life, then make efforts. If you already have children, I tell you about the motivation for parents with children. Well, you have children, you had given birth to them. Now you have learned that everything is actually serious, that there is reincarnation, transformation, and you used to live like normal people. Your children well to a so-called common kindergarten, and then to a common school. Maybe some children have already graduated from the institute. And who has grown by this kindergarten, the school, and the social institute from your child? The consumer. Whose child is not the consumer? Raise your hand. No hands? Really? I wonder why so. A strange statistics. And you gave birth to your child into this world, but you missed the moment and he was made the consumer. And if your children does not reincarnate in a good way, you will be responsible because you have your child in this world and because of you he degraded to a lower level. So your motivation now is to practice yoga and not for yourself but for him, because you will hardly be able to change your child after he was processed. He is like an animal, he will go his own way. And to break him is senseless, but I repeat it once again, and now you have to deal with yourself and for your child. This is not a joke that if your child is degraded and reincarnate badly. It's logical, you understand. If the child, or I don't know, there is a relative who degrades, at first we only talked about pleasant things. The relatives degrade and I said to fight for them. I have told you about the one side of the problem, because the second side, the problem side, how to say, is useless to tell if you are not a yogi yet. And now you are not a yogi yet, but yogis are, had to say the second side of the problem. They took part in your karma. They became what they became, only in order to keep a certain sense. And now it is already your responsibility, and you need to practice yoga for yourselves and for them. Clear? Here's a motivation for married people. What? All the same, because your life now is your life as a caring person and a yogi, basically. A yoga teacher must not be indifferent. An indifferent yogi won't survive now. There is also competition among the teachers of yoga, and indifferent yogi can earn money easily in some other places, and people feel it very well, and accordingly he will make efforts, but the core is that parents had formed your energetic and physical body. It is interrelated. Did you understand this? There are no practices which exist separately. No, they exist, but it's not for you. That is, there are some rituals there, but it's almost like a shamanism. It is better not to deal with this. The most important principles to live honestly, in harmony with nature, and you will be okay. And your relatives also, for many, many corps ahead, because all they suffered to give birth to you, if you become an adequate person, and you will bear this soundness into the society to make the society healthier. Well, I hope I have motivated all of you. First, I had motivated you with carrot. Now I have shown you the reverse side of reality. Well, on that note, let's go to larvas. Listen, how can we do without them, okay? Oh, as usual, we stayed too long already. Well, I have already told you everything. That's all your passion that you have when you say, I want, make conscious that someone wants something from you. You are just so much in hassle that you identify it with your desire. All the desires that will rent your energy convert your life energy into the sense. Clear? No? Not clear. And what is not clear? Well, the girl says that it is not clear, so I ask you, what is not clear? Have you watched the film Moscow 2017? Have you watched it? Of course. Have you seen how the boy was drowning to that barn? There is such an ocean larva. Well, listen, it is another story. Well, they suck your life energy according to your karma. Why do I say according to your karma? Desires are as such are formed not for a reason. Now in this life, you are a wonderful wife to your husband. You cook for him, you make him pleasure, you accumulated karma, the karma of service. Listen, I cannot tell you this because you are Vaishya in the majority. Therefore, life according to your laws. If someone will ever go to the teaching course, I will tell you the plain truth. Now, live as you live. Indeed, it is impossible to tell you, because you should carry out your duties. But the reason the larvas come to you is in that having accumulated the graduates, for example, of your husband through food, or you can't convert that energy. It remains energy, and then this energy makes you eat or be greedy. This energy of the Manipura chakra that eats you, so to say. If you want to be a good wife, you need to be a good yogini. So you should convert the energy constantly with which you received from him. Well, it sounds awless, but it is the hard truth. For example, if you have a passion for good, if you practice yoga for yourself, then maybe it's not the best wish. But you will say that I have children, husband, relatives, my family. If you want to practice yoga and practice, and if you have a family, at least you practice for them, so to say, they also get a certain benefit, a certain percentage. So practice positively. I like, for example, what I like in fact a little, well, I even don't know what I like. When the state I would live to be not, I don't know. I have two more days here to say. Then it will be a break for 5 days. And then it will be the teaching course for 19 days, then 10 days of Vipassana. Then it will be a break again. I took 2 days off on purpose. The guys were given my lessons. Then I come here for these 15 days, so to say, 5 days here, 5 days there, 5 days in the Crimea. Then I have 5 days off, then 21 days of Tibet with the large group, and it will be very hard time. And then when I come back, the full course will start, and then, well, in short, I'm telling you, as you are there, there are factors, but you do not understand what it is. Well, in general, it is not so easy. I'll tell you a secret. And when you live like this from year to year, well, it's actually not so bad, believe me. But no leaks of the energy. Every gram of the energy goes straight into some deed. It is the most effective form of the life. It is another story according larvas. If you are prevented by your passions, then keep in mind you can practice yoga. You can satisfy some passion. Once you satisfy your passion, you can't practice yoga until you accumulated energy. Do you understand this? I will give you a good example. If you are a young man and sometimes you do fun so on this level, respectively, then try to understand these pleasures and then go to a yoga class to see what happens with your body. The vast majority of your body will be stiff only in the case that you are an energetic vampire. So to say, if you take the energy from your victim, then you will even practice yoga and you will have a drive. But again, this is a very dangerous thing because, well, it is bad to be a vampire. I just tell you by secret. Either they burn their life now, or then you will be sucked later. Well, I hope that is all. Any more questions, additions, comments? Okay. Every person has its own leaks. That is your weaknesses where the energy flows. For everybody these weaknesses, there are different practices. In an absolute sense, there is the most efficient is what I have told you. Load yourself so that you have not a drop of energy that you had for nothing. Not even to spend. So to say, in order to always get your energy, even just in some minus, then nobody can take something from you. You invest effectively all your energy into the good things. To live productively, you have to understand at what level you have a problem and apply diametrically opposite efforts. Now, in short, I tell you about chakras in order for you to understand it more or less. If anger arises, how can it be treated? Patience. Sit in any stable asana, sit and weep. If you feel pain, if you regularly feel pain from your body, you have no problems with your anger. All your foolishness will go away. It will go away through the pain. That is such a low level, the same as anger. If you have lust, how can it be treated? Well, in different ways, actually. Smert is one thing for Vesya, another for Kshatri, the third, for the Brahman, the fourth one. Vesya will be said that he can't practice yoga, give birth to the child, and even better to three. All the lust will go away. I mean the main thing that you see the process from the beginning to the end. And trust me, you sober up quickly. The night will be set to make some practices. Yes? Yes, run 5 kilometers with obstacles, or is there something physical, or do something physical. For example, it is a very good healing. For sorcery, accordingly, well, it is a difficult topic. Well, in general, there are some methods. There is a concept that often lust on the energetic level is in the man, and to remove this passion, you should clean the bowel. There are different methods of bowel cleaning of meat. Well, not only meat, but also all the products of meat. I mean to have no toxins. Meat is the cause of toxins. Who doesn't believe watch please yesterday's film? Who didn't watch, ask Volodya Vasilyev to download. Ask him, it is a very good lecture that explains everything. They are a lot, most luckily, but in Russian language, probably very few people who know English translate and share this. A moment, please. Therefore, clean the bowels. There will be fewer problems. Meat can be a major factor. It is, in fact, so avoid meat, but not immediately, because if you stop just yesterday to eat meat, it's not the fact that today you will be fine. You need some time to completely replace the bacteria that live in your body. Well, accordingly, the Manipura chakra. I have already said, learn to sacrifice, do good things, unselfish serving. Learn how to do good things, so to say, learn to give all things you have, not to pull everything for yourself. As a child who is born, wants everything for himself. Learn to give all things. It will also help to overcome the Manipura chakra, Anahata chakra, warmth. Well, to love the whole world is better than to eat or to spend your time for nothing or be angry. But, nevertheless, it is also the energy leaking. A man who loves is a fool because he is cheated. You are all good men. Well, so why do you take loans? Just do nothing, watch TV and do the other useless things. Because you are used, but you are all good, kind and warm people. What does it mean? While you have your energy at the level of the heart of Anahata chakra, you will not understand what is about. Only if you are free from your love, you will be able to see many things to understand what is going on around. But if you want at least to overcome these three problems, love is already a very good thing, but to go above it, you will have to leave this level. It doesn't mean that you will be cold or senseless, as one lady had said. No, you won't be indifferent. Yes, indifferent anyway, right? Not quite cold. If you need to go down, you can always go down to hug your beloved and show your feelings, but then return to be adequate. Well, in short, Vishuddha chakra is 100 times better than Anahata. I love Vishuddha people. They are real. He said, he did. It is cool to deal with them because all that I said previously were just tears and weepies. You know, the circumstances have changed, they could say, and they begin to tell you something strange. Well, it is terrible. And those who are below, they're like animals. So I like Vishuddha people very, very much.
Их очень люблю.